beautiful 32, 34 degree day. That's Celsius,
not Fahrenheit, for your American viewers.
And what are we doing? Sweating our balls off, welding together this car. This here's a figure eight car, guys, so don't tell me that I'm cheating. I'm not. Figure eight has no rules. But, so what we've done here is we have some cross bracing, which is actually a sway bar for conveyor welded in there. We have a little bit of unistrut welded all the way back by the strut towers. The fender's being rolled over and welded to it. 2.5 by 2.5 angle across. I believe that is just a Montana bumper with some steel stuffed inside of it. The blue uprights are actually motor adjusters from work. We should really take out the bolts, I guess. Yeah, just a whole lot of welding done to the front of this car. The back of the car is going to get probably a tuck trunk bar from strut tower to strut tower. And maybe a tuck of trunk and stuff like that, but not too much. This is going to be Curtis's new figure eight car for this year. But yeah, we're just about halfway done on it. We got the fuel tank out. I built him a new fuel tank. So that will be going in today. It did kind of burn my hand pretty good, but I'm recovering, which is always a good thing. So, I don't know if you can see it, but there's my hand. Got the thumb pretty good, and the pointer finger, and this finger, and that finger. Not as bad, but still got them. But, always trying to work on the derby cars, getting another one done and out onto the track. That's what our goal is for today.
So, the trunk is done. What we ended up doing was folding it down, and then welding a half-cut piece of I-beam, and then bolting it through the frame at the back. Cut out the torch, threw the chains over, gave her a quick bend. Fuel tank has the original sending unit back into it now, where it just plugs back into the factory harness. Not the way I do it normally, but Curtis only does box cavaliers, so you know this will work perfect for him, and he only does figure eight. So this setup here, he'll be able to unplug it from this car and plug it right into the next one, so that will work to his advantage. We did a little bit of creasing on the fenders, mostly just to bring it down so we can weld it to this unistrut we got underneath there. And then the front of this car has now got the modified bumper, rad support, sway bracing, a little bit of reinforcement up to the strut towers. I think this car is going to do pretty good for him. It's now got an auxiliary fuel tank in it, doesn't have the stock one, but yeah, it'll get smashed up in a couple figure eights here to come.